Okay, so in the previous class we have gone through the MOSFET scaling. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in the previous class we have gone through MOSFET scaling. So in that scaling we have seen there are two types of scaling, that is constant electric field and another one is constant voltage. Okay, so from that we have seen like if constant voltage scaling is there, means voltage will be remaining constant and all other parameters will be affected, and that will be scaled with a scaling factor of S. So because there were limitation like voltages cannot be reduced after a certain level, so that's why we will keep on using that constant voltage scaling for practical purposes. Okay. So voltages will not be scaled with respect to other parameters. So we will be using constant voltage scaling. So next we need to see is the short channel effects. So what are the different short channel effects? So we have short channel effects. So as the name suggests, if it is a short channel, means the channel length. Channel length of the device or the MOSFET that will be represented by L should be short. Short means it should be small. So how small it should be, the value of L should be, like it can be considered as a short channel device. So for that we will compare it with the dimensions of depletion layer. Okay. So in the MOSFET, if this is the structure, this is N. So this is the channel region. So in between channel region, there is a layer of depletion region. So what is the width of depletion layer? Okay, X, D. Okay, so whatever this XT is there, if the channel length of the device is comparable with the depletion width, then that device would be considered as a short channel device. That means if the channel length of a device is of the same order of the magnitude as the depletion region thickness of the drain and source junction. So at the drain junction, at the source and at the drain junction, width of the depletion layer, if that width or that thickness is having the similar magnitude with respect to the channel length, then that device will be considered as having a short channel. Okay, so there is a limitation to the channel length that should be incomparable thickness to that of the depletion region thickness. Okay, so effectively we call it the L effective. So whatever length will be there after having the total length, that will be effective length if that is of the order of this junction width or junction depth. The same we call it short channel device. So basically it affects and the device and basically affects two parameters. So we will see like how it broadly affects these two physical phenomena that takes place after short channel effects. That will be the electron drift characteristics. So in the channel region, so if the this is the MOSFET, and suppose this is your gate, and this is the drain and source region. So in the channel region, so whatever electrons are there, because the channel length is short, so there will be effect on the movement or the transfer of these electrons. So whatever movement of electrons will be there, that will be given by the electron drift, like the movement of electrons will be in the form of drift current, or you consider drift diffusion or drift. Okay, so this drifting of electrons will be affected by the short channel effect. Okay, so this is the broader way to note it down. The another one is the modification of threshold voltage. Okay, so if the channel length is reduced, the threshold voltage of the device will also be affected. Okay, so this threshold voltage will be affected due to the shortening of channel length. So how it will affect, we will see it later. So in this limitation imposed on the electron drift, it will affect basically the velocity of electron. So whatever velocity the electron is moving, that is called drift velocity. And because of the short channel effect, the velocity, that drift velocity, can go for a saturation velocity. That means the velocity will be saturated. So if it is saturated, magnitude will be reaching to 10 power 7 centimeter per second. If the drift velocity reaches to 10 power 7 centimeter per second, then that velocity is called saturated drift velocity. Okay, so the electric field in the channel region would be in the y-axis, or either it could be in x-axis direction. Okay, these are the direction. So this saturation of drift velocity will be because of the electric field in the y direction. So whatever electric field will be there, that will be very high. Okay, in the y direction, that will make the VD to saturate, and that once the velocity of electron saturated, it will affect the current conduction also. Okay, so based on that, at that time in the saturation region, the current will be given by whatever the current equation we have seen for the saturation current in the saturation region, the ID value we have already seen the expression, that depends on the gate to source voltage. So it is in proportional to VGS minus VT whole square. Okay, so that proportionality is basically represents the square law function or a quadratic function. Okay, but once the short channel device is there, this quadratic function will not be followed. Okay, so the new saturation current will be given by this expression. So here we can see, like, it is having no dependence on gate to source voltage, so VGS is not going to affect if the saturation current, if device is of short channel device. Okay, another one is also the length. There is no effect of length on this drain. So the length will also be not affecting the saturation current. Okay, so the effect that the parameters that will be affecting will be the width of the device. Okay, and the saturation velocity, whatever saturation velocity is there, VD sat value is there, and the oxide capacitance. So these are the parameters that will be constituting the substrate or drain current in the saturation region. So finally, we can see here, like, no saturation quadratic function with respect to VGS is there, and also it is independent of the channel length. So this is how we can get the effect of saturation, the effect of a short channel device on the saturation current. And also we can see in terms of mobility. So the velocity of our electrons also related to the mobility also. Okay, So because of the scattering of charge carriers, so what happens in the channel region, some gate voltage also applied. Okay, so because of this gate voltage, the electrons may scatter to the outside region or the surface region. It means the region at which the interface of oxide and semiconductor is there. So there could be a chance like a scattering of electrons can be there. So this influence of scattering of carriers in the surface will be making the mobility will be affected also. So in terms of that, if there is scattering of charge carriers are there, then mobility could be given by another formula, and that will be affected by mu n zero divided by 1 plus eta VGS minus VT. So this VGS minus VT parameter will be affecting the mobility at that time. So if VGS minus VT parameter is high at that time, this mobility will be reduced in case of short channel devices. This is for short channel devices only. Okay. So in case of short channel devices, the mobility will be affecting. Once the mobility will be affected, the velocity of charge carriers electrons will be affected, and the current conduction will be affected. Okay. So finally, the ID will be affected. So because of the short channel effects, the electron drift is being affected, and the threshold voltage. In that electron drift effect can be because of the electric field. Okay. In that electric field, we are having VGS and channel length effect. So that channel length effect and gate to source voltage will not be affecting the current once the saturation has reached. And another way is like because of the scattering of charge carriers into the surface region or outside region, there will be an effect on the mobility function that will be affecting the saturation current. So now we will see the threshold voltage effect. So this short channel will be causing the modification in the threshold voltage. So instead of having a regular threshold voltage or threshold voltage is constant, the threshold voltage will be changing with respect to the channel length. So basically, whenever you have studied, the threshold voltage is always a constant value. Okay, so we have seen like the threshold voltage is always constant, but once the channel length of the device is reduced or it is incomparable to the depletion region rate, then at that time the threshold voltage shows some modification. So how that modification could be, so we'll see it. So from this figure we can see, like, if this is the channel region, so after some VDS applied and we are also having VGS greater than VT, we can see like the channel, instead of being a rectangular, so this channel should be in the rectangular form like this. Instead of rectangular channel, it is showing some trapezoidal structure. So this trapezoidal structure is caused because of the higher value of VDS. Once we are increasing the VDS, the depletion region between, because this is reverse bias, this is N-type and this is P-type, so this junction will be reverse biased. Because of this, there will be high depletion region. So depletion region in this region, this direction, at that point will be high with respect to this one. Okay, so this affects your threshold voltage. So because of this, the charge at this point will be given by the extra length that is there. So this extra length will be affecting the charge, the number of charge presented at this point. So because of this extra charge in the depletion region, the depletion width will be affected. Okay, and this will finally lead us to the threshold voltage value. So this is the threshold voltage expression, because in the derivation of the formula for threshold voltage, we have seen like the four parameters were there that were affecting the threshold voltage. So one of the four parameters were depletion charge also. So one of that four parameter is the depletion charge. So whatever charge is present in the depletion region, that will be affecting the threshold voltage. This waiting. Okay. So if threshold voltage is affected by depletion charge, so as depletion charge has increased, then only the depletion width has increased. So number of depletion charge is increasing, and that was in the negative direction. So it will be affecting the threshold voltage, and its value will be given by this expression, the complete after combining all the parameters. And one thing we need to take it out, like this term, this is xj divided by L. So here, if L value is large, then xj by L value will be very low. It will be low. Okay, if this is large, then it will be like a zero. If this is zero, then there will be no effect on the threshold voltage. So all the terms will be zero. So as from this value, we can see like the large, if large channel length is there, then there will be no effect on the threshold voltage. But if this threshold, this channel length is small, okay, if this threshold voltage channel length is small, this small value is there, then xj by L will be a large value. So we need to consider the modification into the threshold voltage. So in the starting, we have seen like the short channel effect is going to affect the threshold voltage. So this will be in the terms of xj divided by L. So length is small, then only its effect will be there. And xj, so xj we can see here like whatever the this overlapping is there, that is your xj value is there, junction depth we call it, and this is junction depth, and this one is depletion width. Okay, so this is depletion depth, we can also call it. This is the junction depth, and this is the depletion depth. Okay, so as it is increasing because of the short channel and high voltage applied, this value will be causing the modification of the threshold voltage. So based on that, we have some example. One example is there. So different parameters of an n-channel device is given, like Na is given, okay, and polysilicon doping is also given, TOX oxide thickness is given, and number of fixed charge into the oxide region. ND is given for highly doped N plus region. Okay. And NI is the impurity into the P-TEC. So what happens? So the MOSFET, so basically in the channel region, is implanted with the P-TEC impurity. Okay. That is having a concentration of this to adjust the threshold voltage. So what happens? So into the channel region. Okay. So in the channel region, we basically modify the channel region by using some adjustment by P-type impurity and doping that is having concentration of this amount. And junction depth and diffusion region depth is given by like this xj equals to 1 micrometer. So finally, we need to plot the threshold voltage, zero bias threshold voltage, that is VT zero, as a function of channel length. Okay, and also we need to find out VT zero for L equals to this value, and here the VDS and the other parameters are given. So to have that, we have the formula. So by using the formula, we can directly find out VT zero. VT zero value we can find out. So this is the VT value by using the VT formula, whatever VT formula we are having in the previous discussion. So that will be 0.4 volt, and this is being increased because of the charge into the, that is extra doping that we have done into the diffusion region, because to maintain the channel region to maintain the threshold voltage. So threshold voltage ko adjust karne ke liye we have extra doping. So because of that, voltage will be added to have threshold voltage. So this will be the modified one after including the this impurity concentration. So this is the threshold voltage, and at that time we have assumed VSB is zero. So the next threshold voltage will be because of the short channel effect. So once we will be considering short channel effect, then that short channel effect will be causing the reduction in the threshold voltage. So this is basically the amount that will be reduced. Okay. So to calculate this value, we need to have XD, okay, and XJ, and all these parameters are given already. So XD and XJ we need to find out. So that value will be the depletion. First of all, we need to have built-in potential, because to find out XD or XD and XS, we need to have built-in potential. So built-in potential we will find out by KT by Q ln NANT divided by NI square. So this will be the potential will be generated across the gate and substrate region or channel region. Okay, it will be in the oxide, in between the oxide. So now next value we will be finding is XD and XS. Just wait for a minute. Okay, so sorry for the pause. Actually, there was some issue with the attendance. Okay, so next we will find out the XD and XD for S region, source region, and XD for drain region. And its formula will be this. Okay, this formula we have already seen in like in the previous some classes. And here the X value of built-in potential we need to use. So that's why we have computed in the previous. For drain region, and this is for source region. That will be same. We have considered that it is same. Okay. So by putting these values, we can get the value of change in threshold voltage. Okay. So this change in threshold voltage will be subtracted. This is in terms of length, L already. So L value is not given. So the analysis will be terms of in L value. So that the final short channel the threshold voltage after adding short channel effect will be this one. So 0.855 volt minus 0.19 volt. This will be after calculation we will be getting 0.19 volt with respect to L. L also L will be an parameter. So after plotting this, we will get this plot. Okay. this is how we can proceed for solving the numericals. So, and another concept here is like we are considering the so some of the modifications, like that's in the conventional threshold voltage expression, that is this one is not applicable for accounting for this drastic reduction of threshold voltage at a smaller channel length. So whatever threshold voltage expression we have studied, that cannot include the short channel effect. So that's why that expression that we have, that is the generalized expression, cannot be applied to the short channel MOSFETs. So it should threshold voltage expression. Okay. So next one is we have given a condition. So VDS is given and other values are given. Based on that, we will find out the VDS. Okay. So VDS value is given. So XD, and again another depletion width we will find with by considering the applied voltage. Okay. So after applying this, we will be getting another one. This is the modified depletion width after applying drain to source voltage, and with respect to that we will again calculate the threshold voltage. That this is change in threshold voltage, and this change in threshold voltage will be subtracted from the threshold voltage which is zero value, and that this will be the final threshold voltage after applying the short channel effect and also applying the VDS value. Okay. So in the previous one, this value was before applying any VDS value. There were no VDS value. We are just considering the depletion region without any applied voltage at the drain and source channel. Okay. So the next topic is narrow channel devices. So narrow channel effects. So what happens? We have seen like short channel effect. Okay. So we have seen short channel effect. This one is narrow channel effect. So in the short channel effect, what we have seen is length should be comparable with XT. So the depletion width hai uske comparable hona chahiye short channel effects ke liye, theek. Then it is called short channel device. But in case of narrow channel device, if any device is there that is of narrow channel, at that time what we need to consider is, instead of channel length, we will be considering channel width. If channel width of the of that device on the same order of magnitude as the magnitude depletion magnitude of the maximum depletion region thickness, so whatever depletion region thickness is there, that is XDM, is the depletion region thickness is there, if that XDM is having a comparable channel width, so instead of channel length, this depletion region width should be incomparable to the channel width of the device, then that device will be considered as narrow channel device. And because of this narrow channel device, the performance of device can be affected, then that effects will be called narrow channel effects. Okay. The actual threshold voltage of such devices is larger than that of the predicted by conventional threshold voltage. So the basic difference will be, if the channel width is of the comparable magnitude with respect to the maximum depletion region thickness, the threshold voltage will be higher than the conventional threshold voltage. But in case of short channel effects, the threshold voltages were reduced. So it was threshold voltage minus change in threshold voltage. Okay. So in case of short channel effect, short channel devices, the threshold voltage were reduced. But in case of narrow channel devices, the threshold voltages will be higher than the conventional voltages. Okay. So also the fringe depletion region under the fixed oxide. So there is fringe depletion region is there. So because of this narrow channel effect, the threshold voltages depletion region will be in case of near the drain and source region, and that will be affecting with increase in the threshold voltage. And also that change in threshold voltage value will be given by 1 by COX, that was there also, and these are the parameters were there. So the only affecting parameter will be XDM, that is width, that is thickness of your depletion region, okay, divided by width. So if this width is large, then this value will be zero. So otherwise, then change in the threshold voltage will be zero. But if these two are of comparable magnitude, then it will be having some finite value. This finite value will be causing the change in the threshold voltage. Okay. So here, key value that we are can see here is like pi by 2 for depletion region modeled by quarter circular arc. So this is the depletion region. This is the fringe one. So it is like 1/4 of a circle. Okay. So a complete circle is there. So 1/4 of circle will be there. This will be the extra depletion region, that is fringe depletion region under the filled oxide. So whatever filled oxide is there, there will be extra depletion region on the both side. Okay. So this will be causing you increase in threshold voltage. Okay. So this is called narrow channel effect. So there are some other short channel effects. So these are other limitations imposed by a small device geometry. So this is like other short channel effects. So what are the different other short channel effects? We will see one by one. Okay. So subthreshold conduction is there. So in that subthreshold conduction, that is called, in case of subthreshold conduction, means we are having VGS less than VT. At this point also, the current through the drain terminal is not equals to zero. Zero current nahi hota hai. It is always in the form of either nanoampere. Okay. So if the transistor is on, if the channel is on, that is VGS is greater than VT. So whatever ID will be there, that will zero. Okay. And it will be in the form of microampere. ठीक है. समटाइम्स ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन पूछे जाते हैं ऐसे कि अगर ट्रांजिस्टर अगर ऑन है उस टाइम पे जो करंट फ्लो होगा थ्रू द ट्रांजिस्टर विल बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ माइक्रो एम्पियर्स और मिली एम्पियर. ओके. बट इफ द ट्रांजिस्टर इज ऑफ और द करंट इज फ्लोइंग इन द नैनो एम्पियर देन दैट ट्रांजिस्टर विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज ऑफ वन एंड इट कुड ऑल्सो बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ सब थ्रेशोल्ड करंट कंडक्शन. ओके. So if the current flowing through a transistor is in nano ampere, that will be a subthreshold current conduction. Okay. So a non-zero drain current ID for VGS less than VT will be there, and its expression will be this one. So ID saturation will be given by this one. Iska simplified modification ek hota hai, that is mu n COX W by L. Neta is there, that is subthreshold flow, multiplied by this is this term e to the power this term, complete this term will be your multiplied by this one. This will be the modified one. This is used for generalized device algorithm circuit implementation whenever we are going for operating MOSFET in the sub threshold region. So analysis of this transistor can be done by this modified expression that is generally used by researchers. Okay. So the subthreshold conduction will be when the VGS is less than VT, then whatever current will be flowing through the transistor, drain current, that will be considered subthreshold current. This expression will be this. Another one is punch through. So the punch through is given by, like, as the drain current is increased further after the VDS if we are going to have increased drain current, then there comes a time when the depletion region near the drain and source touches each other. That means whatever happens, so whatever drain depletion region is there, so some depletion region will be there here, okay, and the depletion region will be here. So whenever these two depletion regions will be touching each other, okay, so once we are increasing the drain current, so drain current we are increasing, and at that time this depletion region is being touched by both the sides, in the source side and the drain side. At that point, whatever applied voltage or the drain current is there, then that merging of depletion regions will be considered as the point of punch through. So punch through and pinch off, these two are different points. So these are so pinch off, we have already known in the saturation region, the pinch off point will be there when VDS is greater than or equal to VD set. Okay, then this pinch off point will be there. But punch through is the point when the drain current that is applied to the device, at that time the depletion region on drain side and source side becomes equal and they touch each other. That will be considered as the punch through point. Okay, at this point the current rises sharply. Okay, at this point the current will be rising, and gate at this point the gate will be losing its control on the drain current. So once the punch through has reached, there will be no control of gate terminal voltage to control the drain current of the device. Okay, and also the current will be rising sharply once the punch through has occurred, and it can cause permanent damage to the device. So as the punch through takes place, there will be increase in current that will be a sharp increase. Once there will be a sharp increase, that can affect or that can damage the device. Okay, so it should be avoided, the punch through condition should be avoided. The next one is, okay, so this is oxide. Gate oxide thickness TOX is equal to this one is restricted by processing default. So what happens, so whenever we are going to reduce the oxide thickness, we cannot reduce it beyond a particular value. Okay, so because at that time if it is very small, we cannot process it, we cannot aggregate it, so it will be causing difficulty. So another point, that is hot carrier effect. So what happens, so hot carrier effect is arises due to hot carrier injection phenomena. So what happens in hot carrier injection, that is occurs when large VDS, so whatever drain to source voltage, that this is VDS, so whatever VDS we are applying, when a large VDS is applied, and at this point as we are applied the higher drain to source voltage, so electric field, whatever electric field is there in this direction, that is EY, that will be keep on increasing. Okay, so there will be a point such that the electrons arriving at the silicon, this is and SiO2 junction at the interface side, will have large kinetic energy. Once it will be having a large kinetic energy, then the potential barrier will be causing an injected electron into the oxide. So what happens, the whatever electrons are there, we are increasing the VDS value. This VDS value will be causing the higher electric field into the y direction or horizontal direction. This will move the provide higher kinetic energy to would be transferring from source to drain side. This will be constituting in the drain current. But some of the high speed electrons can enter into the oxide. So this is how the electrons can be into the oxide region, can reach the oxide region. So electron hole pair generation by the impact ionization also contribute to electron injection. This will be causing the hot carrier injection effect near the drain region. So what happened? Whatever electrons are there, they will be colliding with each other there, and also they will be moving to the drain side. So after colliding, they will be generating electrons and hole pairs, and some of the electrons will be moving towards the oxide region that will be in the drain direction. So this is drain region. So drain region ke direction mein some electrons will be moving into the oxide region. So because of this, they are moving moving electrons, high speed moving electrons having high kinetic energy. That's why these electrons are called hot electrons or hot carrier. So that's why this effect of movement of charge carriers into the oxide region is given by hot carrier effects. Okay, so that will reduce the overall current conduction of the circuit, the device. Okay, so this are the some parameters or effects that are generated at the small device geometry. Because of the small device effects, these phenomena or processes can be occurring and affecting the device performance. So there are some other also, so that is given by, like, we call it DIBL. DIBL, we have seen, this is DIBL. DIBL is drain induced barrier lowering. So as the name suggests, so this occur in case of subthreshold conduction. So if the gate current is there, so whatever drain induced barrier lowering means, if we are applying some drain voltage, so if we are applying some drain voltage, at that time the barrier lowering means the barrier voltage that is built in potential will be there, that is being reduced once we are applying a drain to source voltage. So drain to source voltage, as the drain voltage is increased in case of DIBL, when we are increasing the drain to source voltage, the barrier potential of the MOSFET, so whatever potential across this that will be built in potential or barrier potential will be there, that will be reduced. This is generally gate voltage is used to reduce the barrier. So in the MOSFET, basically the how we are reducing the barrier potential by using the gate terminal. So whatever gate voltage we are applying with respect to that, either it is channel formation will be taking place after reduction of this barrier voltage. But this barrier voltage can also be reduced by the drain voltage that we are applying. So once we are applying the drain voltage and the barrier is being reduced, then that is called drain induced barrier lowering. Okay. So this can be caused in case of short channel devices only. Okay. So another some effects are like the velocity saturation we have already seen. So what is velocity saturation? So this velocity saturation is when we are applying high electric field. Okay, so high electric field will be higher drain voltage. Once we are applying a higher drain voltage, higher electric field will be there. That higher electric field will speed up the electron velocity, and that electron velocity will finally be reached to 10^7 centimeter per second. So that will saturate the charge carrier's velocity. So velocity charge carriers, that is proportional to electric field. So because of that short channel length, the velocity can be increased because of the high electric field. So this is called the velocity saturation. And impact ionization is another one. So whatever we have seen, like hot carrier injection or hot carrier effect, in that hot carrier effect, so once the electric field is high, the electrons get more kinetic energy, so kinetic energy will be increased. So these highly energized electrons will be breaking the covalent bonds, and we will be generating electron and hole pairs. So this generation of electron and hole pair, because of high electric field inside the channel region, is called impact ionization. Okay. So after impact ionization, the hot carrier effects will be there. These hot carriers will be generating more number of electron and hole pair, and electrons will be moving towards the oxide region. That is called hot carrier effects. And mobility reduction we have already seen in the previous class, mobility reduction and threshold reduction also. So these are there are different effects. Okay, so these are up to the your short channel effects. So next we will see in the next class, like some other topics that will be there. और किसी को कोई डाउट है इसमें?